Shalom semua, selamat kembali ke Ikebaktian pada minggu ini. Terima kasih sebab terus setia bersama dengan BEM Shalom. The more you come, the more you like this place. Kami berharap anda sentiasa sihat sejahtera, damai bersuka cita di hati dan di mata. Oh ya, jangan lupa jaga fizikal dan emosi juga ya guys. Pada hari ini, kita akan mengadakan perjamuan suci. Anda semua bolehlah menghidangkan jus anggur dan roti di tempat masing-masing. Walaupun kita jauh di mata, tapi dalam Kristus kita tetap dekat di hati. Jadi marilah kita sama-sama mengambil bagian dalam perjamuan suci ini. Selamat beribadah dan Tuhan memberkati anda semua.
Bapa kami yang di syurga, terima kasih untuk pagi ini Tuhan yang telah Kau berikan kepada kami. Pada pagi ini Tuhan, kami ingin mengangkat beberapa perkara doa ke dalam tangan-Mu. Yang pertama Tuhan, kami berdoa bagi gereja Shalom, terutamanya bagi para leaders dan komite. Kami berdoa Tuhan agar hikmat dan pengetahuan Kau berikan kepada mereka dalam mereka merangka pelayanan yang sesuai dalam masa akan datang. Kami juga berdoa agar Kau terus mencukupi keperluan gereja, terutamanya dari segi keuangan dan tenaga pelayan-pelayan bagi pelayanan kerajaan gereja. Seterusnya Tuhan, kami serahkan Shalom Family ke dalam tangan-Mu. Kami berdoa Bapa agar Kau terus memenuhi keperluan rohani keluarga jemaat Shalom, agar asas keluarga terus tumbuh dalam Tuhan Yesus dalam semua musim kehidupan. Kami juga berdoa agar Kau terus memberkati anak-anak yang masih belajar, agar iman mereka tetap terus teguh dan terus diperlengkapi oleh firman Tuhan dalam kehidupan mereka. Kami juga menyerahkan students ke dalam tangan-Mu. Kami berdoa Tuhan agar terus jemput tangan dalam persiapan mereka menghadapi final exam dan juga assignment mereka. Dan kami juga berdoa agar Engkau terus menyertai, memperlengkapi dan memberkati mereka. Yang terakhir, kami berdoa bagi working adults. Kami berdoa Bapa agar mereka dapat menjadi penyalur berkat kepada orang di sekeliling mereka, masyarakat, ekonomi negara dan juga gereja. Kami berdoa bagi yang mencari pekerjaan agar mereka terus diperlengkapi dengan kekuatan rohani dan usaha yang tidak putus-putus dalam mencari pekerjaan. Terima kasih Bapa, ini doa kami, semoga dipenuhi pekerjaan hanya di dalam nama Tuhan Yesus. Kami telah berdoa. Amin.
Shalom dan selamat pagi kepada kita semua. Bertemu lagi kita dalam Ikebaktian BEM Shalom pada pagi hari ini. Saya percaya dimanapun kita berada, Tuhan menyertai kita semua. Sekarang saya mengajak kita semua untuk bersama-sama menyanyikan lagu pujian ini dengan mengatakan Tuhan penebusku. Kita percaya bahwa kasih Tuhan begitu besar di dalam hidup kita. Mari kita bersama-sama puji dan sembah.
Terima kasih.
Bapa, menyembah dan memuliakan Engkau pada ketika ini Bapa. Terimalah pujian penyembahan kami Bapa, dan berkenan di hadapan-Mu ya Tuhan Yesus. Dan kami bukakan hati kami Tuhan untuk siap mendengar firman-Mu pada pagi ini Bapa. Segala pujian hormat kami naikkan bagi Engkau ya Bapa, karena Engkau yang layak mendapat pujian dan hormat dari kami Bapa. Terima kasih Tuhan, terima kasih Yesus. Amin.
Selamat pagi. Kita puji Tuhan, kita di minggu yang pertama bulan Ogos tahun 2020. Dan kita akan teruskan ibadah kita pada pagi ini dengan mengambil perjamuan suci. Sarap Anda telah sediakan roti dan air untuk perjamuan ini. Mari kita berdoa. Bapa di surga, terima kasih pagi ini kami dapat mengambil perjamuan suci ini Tuhan. Terima kasih untuk kasih setia Tuhan kepada kami. Aku berdoa supaya Tuhan memberkati perjamuan ini untuk kemuliaan bagi nama-Mu. Dalam nama Yesus Kristus kami berdoa. Amin. Tuhan Yesus pada malam waktu ia diserahkan mengambil roti, dan sudah itu ia mengucap syukur atasnya. Ia memecah-mecahkannya dan berkata, inilah tubuhku yang diserahkan bagi kamu. Perbuatlah ini menjadi peringatan akan aku. Mari kita ambil roti bersama. Demikian juga ia mengambil cawan sesudah makan, lalu berkata, cawan inilah perjanjian baru yang dimeteraikan oleh darahku. Perbuatlah ini setiap kali kamu meminumnya menjadi peringatan akan aku. Sebab setiap kali kamu makan roti ini dan minum cawan ini, kamu memberitakan kematian Tuhan sampai ia datang. Mari kita ambil air itu bersama. Kami bersyukur pada Tuhan. Bapa di surga, terima kasih karena tubuh-Mu dan darah-Mu yang dicurahkan dan dihancurkan untuk pengampunan dosa kami Tuhan. Dan biar kami, kehidupan kami dipakai untuk kemuliaan, memuliakan nama-Mu, dan diguna untuk memberitakan berita baik tentang kasih dan penyelamatan-Mu ya Bapa. Dalam nama Yesus Kristus kami ucap syukur dan berdoa. Amin.
Good morning everyone. This morning I would like to share with you three important social realities facing many Christians, Shalom included, during this COVID-19 crisis. Let me start with this. We are all starting from the same point in our lives as far as salvation is concerned. Meaning, we are all born again, we are transformed through Christ, and we are a new creation. The old has passed, the new has come. So that is what is the basis of our starting point for everyone. Nevertheless, during this crisis, many Christians throughout the world, we are included here in Shalom. There is no exception to anyone here. We are traveling in different roads, or different routes, as the American says. Different positions depending on our status, or the status of salvation, the status of our faith, the status of our maturity and growth in Christ or in Christian faith. So number one, my point number one, or route number one, I look into Psalm 1, first Psalm, verse 2 and 3. But whose delight is in the law of the Lord, and who meditates on his law day and night, that person is just like a tree planted by streams of water, which yields its fruit in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever they do, prosper. So that is number one. Things that I remember for all of us who is in Christ. So, this route number one, if we are delighted in the law of the Lord, meditate upon the law day and night, we experience the desires, the thirsts, and also experiencing the hunger for the Word of God and seeking His kingdom and feeding on His Word. So remember these key words: desire, thirsty, hungry, seeking, and feeding on the Word of God. As newborn baby, we desire pure milk of the Word. That's how we can grow. 1 Peter 2 verse 2. Now Psalm 42 verse 1 and 2 says, as the deer pants for water, so pant my soul for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. Now, remember Psalm 63 verse 1. David is an example where he was in the wilderness of Judah. Oh God, you are my God, I shall seek you earnestly. My soul thirsts for you, my flesh yearns for you, in a dry and weary land where there is no water. So that's how Christians are like. If they are seeking, if they are thirsty, if they are hungry, if they are meditating in the law of the Lord day and night. We are seeking first the kingdom of God and all His righteousness shall be added unto us. So Matthew 6 verse 33. So in order to grow, in order to prosper, in order to be strengthened in our faith, matured, we cannot depend on the milk, baby milk, but must consume solid food. And that's the reason why Jesus taught us His prayer. And one of this, Matthew 6 verse 17, teach us, give us today our daily bread. Now, the reason why is that we cannot live by bread, by food alone. But we must depend on every words that come from the mouth of God daily, not on Sunday alone, not on Wednesday, not on prayer meeting alone, but on the daily bread that come from the mouth, or the words come from mouth of God. Seek the Lord while He may be found, the Isaiah 55. You see, call unto Him while He is near. So this is what we should do. In John 6 verse 35, Jesus said unto them, I am the bread of life. He who comes to me will not hunger, and he who believes in me will never thirst. So man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that come from the mouth of God. So there is a very detailed, interesting, comprehensive warning, and also by Paul here to the church in to Matthew. In the, he said, you need to read the words. 1 Timothy 4 verse 13. You need to study the word, as Paul says in 2 Timothy 2 verse 15. And he could have said that you need to meditate on the word, as in Psalm 19 verse 14, Joshua 1 verse 8, or as in Philippians 4 verse 8. If you think about this, you need even to teach the word. Our responsibility in the church is not only people preaching, but to teach the word as well. You need to preach the word you see, and acts on it, and will on the word like a sword. That is in Ephesians 6. So the word of God is the sword of the Spirit. So it's important for us to dwell in God's abiding presence, as John 15 says. You need to abide in me. My words will abide in you. If we abide in God, He will definitely, surely, 100% beyond your doubt, that He will abide in you. So that is what I call social reality number one. While you dwell in the house of the Lord, you pray, you meditate, and as you meditate, the law of the Lord day and night, as it were in the Bible, you will definitely experience that blessing. Not in only in physical blessing, but also in spirit too. Now, point number two that I would like to share with you is route or social reality number two is route two. And those of us who have experienced the blessing of the Lord for years and years, or after our salvation, but nevertheless, there are areas in our lives and situation where there is crisis, where there is a problem that we face right today. We begin to sit on the fence. This is what I call a fence sitters. Or if you ride on a motorbike, I call you a pylon rider in the back, not a driver. You are neither there, nor here, nor there, enjoying what you call both life in this world. Christians living like this is those who sit on the fence, or depending on the faith of the pastors, or depending on the faith of others for livelihood, for living, actually living in a very in a danger zone, I call it danger zone, because if you're not careful, you can fall. If you're careful, you may stay on the fence, enjoying what the blessing of the Lord. At the same time, you're enjoying what the world enjoys too, sitting on the fence. But can be very dangerous for us. People like this, or if we are like this, we are too dependent. People who are dependent on Sunday bread instead of a daily bread. You eat the daily bread, you feel every day. If you depend on the Sunday bread and you don't eat the Monday bread, Tuesday bread, Wednesday bread, you feel hungry the following day, and then and keep on depending on it, your bread will get rotten, and you still eating it, and then your bread get moldy, and then at the same time worms will start growing, fungus will start growing on the bread, and keep eating, and no wonder we become weak, because we don't depend on any nutritious bread, daily bread, but depend on fermented and rotten bread. And again, I come back to this prayer, the Lord's Prayer. He said, "Our Father, thou art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. And let not us into temptation, but deliver us from evil." So this is a very things that Jesus said in his prayer, teaching us how to pray. Now what happens when you're thirsty and hungry? Then you become lukewarm, neither hot nor cold. You see, you're neither there, nor here, nor there. So the term lukewarm comes directly from Revelation, actually, chapter 3, verse 15 to 17. This is the Spirit speaking through John to the church in Laodicea. He said, I know your deeds, that you are neither cold nor hot. I wish you were either one or the other. So because you are lukewarm, neither hot nor cold, I am about to spit you out of my mouth. You say, I am rich, I have acquired wealth, and do not need anything, but you do not realize that you are wretched, pitiful, poor, blinded, and naked. This is a stern warning to all of us, reminding us so that we do not ignore, we do not abandon, we do not leave behind what God has given us, telling us, warning us, alerting us to be on His side, not sitting on somebody on the other side of the fence. This also be exemplified. Oh, the salt, just like the salt has lost its taste. You are the salt of the earth in Matthew 5 verse 13. But if the salt had lost its flavor or savor, how can it be made salty? It is no longer good for anything except to be thrown out and trampled by men. So we're supposed to be salt to make people thirsty for the kingdom of God. Salt is a symbol of Christian discipline, actually. If you are salty, you can be of use. If there is no salt, if it loses saltiness, it cannot be become preservative anymore. We preserve meat, fish, and even vegetables so that it lasts longer, so that we can consume it later, not only today, but tomorrow and day after. So sitting on the fence are potential candidates. If you and I are sitting on the fence today, we are all become potential candidates for the third group, which I call root number two, or social reality number two, that is backsliding game, or turning backward instead of forward. We are sitting or having a faulty radar that do not give us direction, but because we're sitting on the fence, we don't have no compass. Our compass is broken, our compass is no good, because we don't depend on God anymore. We depend on the world. So a warning from Hebrew. He said Hebrew 3 verse 13, 12 and 13 says, take care, brothers, lest there be in any of you an evil, unbelieving heart, lending you to fall away from God, from the living God. But exhort one another every day, as long as it is called today, that none of you may be hardened by the deceitfulness of sin. A warning, so giving us also, telling that if you are weak, your brother or your family members or your friends who are strong need to encourage you, need to alert you, need to exhort you so that you will not fall. To remind you, do not fall into sin. The parable of the soils in Mark 4 verse 14 to 19 also telling us that, we can be, the word of God has been planted in our hearts, but because of thorns and bushes and things rocky grounds, these words will never grow in our hearts, and we can easily be rooted out because our faith is not strong. We are not rooted in our faith. We are not grounded because we live a little on the good soil. There is very little good soil where there is rocks. And if there is good soil, there are also the bush and the lalang. Other plants will start competing with us. You ended up fallen, and you ended up dead. You ended up being wilting, and you ended up being dead, demise by this evil surrounding you. And that is what the parable of the soils. But if you, if the words are planted, fall on the good ground, that words will grow, that word will bear, will flower, will bear fruits and in an abundance. Now Hosea 4 verse 6 reminded us to, you know, if you don't have the word of God in you, dead, my people are dead. For many of us will be dead for the lack of knowledge or spiritual ignorance. So the lack of knowledge of God's word, or abandoning it, taking it for granted, will lead us to be spiritually dead. The fear of the Lord is the beginning of all knowledge and wisdom. So if you lack this fear in you, if you lack words of God in you, you'll be definitely weak, not strong. 1 John 2 verse 15 and 13, do not love the world or things of the world. What are things of the world? They are temptations, things which are not helpful, things which do not build you up in your faith, do not bring you into things which bring you to sins against your, the word of, against God. These are the things that we should be reminded of while we are still living on earth. Now, I would like to follow that up a little bit before I end up. Sign of backsliding or turning back. Number one, neglecting God's word. Matthew 4 verse 4. Men shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that comes from the mouth of God. So know what it means. Our physical body may need food to eat. Okay. But it's not the physical body alone that is important. Remember that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit. Your body needs, your soul needs spiritual food. That's what it means. That's why you need God's word to feed your soul and your spirit so that you become strong, not weak. Okay. Second, there's a losing desire to pray. In Hebrew verse 4, Hebrew 4 verse 16. When we pray, we come to the throne of grace of God, mercy in times of need. So if you don't pray, you don't communicate with God. If you pray, you communicate with God, and His response will be, if you abide in my words, He will abide in you. James 4 verse 8 says, draw near to God, He will draw near to you. Now, nobody is immune to temptation. Nobody is immune to backsliding. Be reminded that. No leader, no one. You're not alone, everyone. But if we confess our sin, He will be faithful and righteous to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. 1 John 1 verse 9. So let me end here with a prayer. Okay, let's all pray. Father, thank you that you have reminded us, warning us, alerting us how important it is for us Christians not to abandon our faith, not to abandon your words, not to be go away from the word of God. Thank you, Lord, that you have sent us your Holy Spirit to counsel us, to teach us, to remind us, and to comfort us. So we depend on you to give us life, to give us hope, to give us strength, to give us your wisdom and insight. So Father, thank you as we ponder upon your word today. Once again, we come before thee and ask of you to be with us, to be your abiding presence be with us, abide in us, Lord Jesus, day and night, as you reminded us to be meditating your word day and night. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Shalom semua, seterusnya kita akan menjalankan itanggo bagi pemberian persepuluhan dan dana bangunan gereja. Berikut adalah butiran account bank. Nama bank RHB Bank, nama account Bonio Evangelical Mission Shalom, nombor account 211128000164 dan jenis account adalah current account. Kepada yang menyumbang, sila share screenshot receipt bank anda. Dan sekiranya terdapat sebarang pertanyaan, sila hubungi person in charge yang tertera di bawah, iaitu Brother John dan Sis Susan. Terima kasih dan Tuhan memberkati anda semua.
Shalom semua. Sekarang kita beralih ke ruang announcement. Di kebaktian pada Mil Hadapan 9 Ogos 2020, pengkhutbah kita ialah Reverend George Pando. Seterusnya anda boleh melayari link tersebut atau scan QR code untuk ke FB page Shalom. BM Church, the more you come, the more you like this place. Thank you for worshiping with us today. See you next week. God bless.